They entered villages and kibbutz farms and found families still in their beds, and they slaughtered them in the most horrific manner.
在那些村民，很多还在床上睡觉的时候，就发现自己被残杀在这里，这个最可怕、最残忍的情况。
They killed 40 babies and they beheaded them. They raped people. They kidnapped people and paraded lifeless bodies throughout the city.
他们杀了40个孩童，把他们头砍下来。他们将庆祝能够残杀这些人，甚至把他们的尸体放在街上来庆祝。
Gaza erupted in celebration, dancing with joy, and many cities around the world followed suit, rejoicing in terrorism, bloodshed, and evil.
而加萨那儿就开始庆祝他们残忍的攻击，甚至世界各地都跟他们一起加入这庆祝邪恶的行列。
They attacked innocent people who were ready to celebrate the final of their autumn holy days, Simchat Torah, which means joy of God's law.
而他们是在以色列，他们庆祝秋季最后一个节期的最后一天，他们这一天称为 Shemak Torah， 代表神律法的喜乐，在这时候袭击。
What happened on October 7 was not natural, it was supernatural, it was demonic. A repeat of what the Nazis went from house to house looking for Jewish families to slaughter and to destroy.
10月7日发生的事不仅是自然界的，这是超自然的，在灵里面就像当年的纳粹，他们挨家挨户去找犹太人，要残杀他们。
So was there a mystery behind what happened in October 7 in Israel, behind Gaza, Hamas?
那到底10月7日在以色列所发生的这一切，在加萨哈马斯集团他们背后真正发生的是什么？
Was it predicted, a prophecy?
在预言里已经预测到了吗？
50 years ago, on October 6, 1973, took place the Yom Kippur War.
而在60年前，当时的大赎罪日战争有类似的情况。
And now, exactly 50 years later, we have seen the same thing happen, a surprise attack on Israel, October 7.
在几十年后的今天，类似的事情再一次重新发生在今年的10月7日。
Today, I will try to give a prophetic understanding of what we see happening today.
今天我试着从先知性的角度来理解到底今天发生了什么事。
But before we begin, I would like to make an important and clear statement to avoid any misunderstandings.
可是正式之前，我想做一个非常清楚的声明，以免大家有任何的误解。
This ministry is not against any people, but we oppose every form of evil.
我们这个事工没有反对任何人，然而我们坚持反对任何邪恶的事。Having
said this, let's get started.
讲完这个，让我们开始。
I am God and there's no one like me, declaring the end from the beginning.
神说无人能像我。 没有能比我，我从起初指明幕后的事。God's
plan of salvation started in the beginning, Genesis.
上帝整个救赎的计划从最起初就开始在创世纪当中。And
I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed, and he shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel.
我要叫你的女人和你和女人彼此为仇，你的后裔和女人的后裔也彼此为仇，女人的后裔要伤你的头，你要伤她的脚跟。God
is angry with Satan, trying to destroy his master plan, and he promises Satan, I will put enmity between you and the woman, Israel, and he will bruise your head, and you will bruise his heel.
上帝恨恶撒旦。 他已经摧毁撒旦所有邪恶的计划，甚至他宣告你和女人就是以色列， 你要伤女人后裔的脚跟，你女人的后裔要伤你后裔的头。
And this with the sons of Abraham, Ishmael and Isaac.
而这从亚伯拉罕的儿子以实玛利跟以撒开始。
Ishmael was the plan of Abraham and Sarah, but Isaac was God's plan.
以实玛利是亚伯拉罕跟撒拉自个儿计划来的，以撒却是上帝的计划。
Isaac was the promised one, the fisherman, and Ishmael was a hunter.
以撒是那应许的儿子，他是渔夫，以实玛利却是猎人。
Ishmael had 12 sons, and in Islamic tradition, Ishmael gave rise to the 12 tribes of Ishmael. In Jewish tradition, the 12 tribes of Israel.
那以实玛利也有十二个儿子，就穆斯林他们的传统，他们认为当时以实玛利的十二个支派，就如同以色列在雅各这里有十二个儿子、十二个支派一样，他们各自称为以实玛利十二支派，以色列的十二支派。
We know from the Bible that God made Ishmael a great nation.
圣经里面我们知道，上帝要使以实玛利成为大国。
According to the Quran, Ishmael moved with Abraham to Saudi Arabia, Mecca.
按照可兰经，他们讲以实玛利跟着亚伯拉罕就搬到了沙特阿拉伯麦加那儿。
And today, Mecca is a central symbol, a focal point of worship for Muslims around the world.
而今天麦加是全世界各地穆斯林他们敬拜朝圣的中心。
Muslims face Mecca 5 times a day when they pray, wherever they are in the world.
穆斯林不管他们在世界哪一个角落，每一天要面向麦加祷告5次。
And what are they praying for?
祷告什么呢？
Fellow Ephesians, doesn't all the world know that the city of Ephesus is the guardian of the temple of the great Artemis and of her image which fell from heaven?
以弗所人呐，谁不知道以弗所人的城是看守大雅典米的庙和从宙斯那里落下来的像呢？
Here we read that Paul speaks of the inhabitants of Ephesians, Asia Minor, who worshipped a piece of stone that fell from heaven.
这里保罗讲到，在以弗所这边的人，在小亚细亚那里，他们朝拜的是从天上掉下的一块石头。
It was believed that this stone came from the sun goddess Artemis.
而他们相信这块石头是从那个太阳女神雅迪米那儿落下来的。
Interestingly, there's a black stone in Mecca, which is the most sacred item in Islam today.
很有意思哦，在麦加那儿有一块黑色石头，也是在伊斯兰当中最为神圣的圣物。
And this stone is displayed in the center of the great mosque in Mecca called Kaaba.
而这块石头今天展示在麦加大清真寺的中央，被称为科尔白。
It is interesting to see all the parallels and contradictions between the Jewish and the Islamic faith, the enmity between the seed of Isaac and Ishmael.
很有意思啊，你看到在犹太人的传统跟这些回教族的传统当中有很多类似雷同的东西，而这正是以撒跟以实玛利后裔这世代为仇的子孙。
Enmity continued when Isaac's wife Rebekah became pregnant by Jacob and Esau.
而整个的仇恨继续下去，当利百加她怀了雅各跟以扫。
And the twins struggled in her womb, and Rebekah asked the Lord, "Why is this happening to me?"
而两个双生子在母亲的腹中相争，利百加就求问上帝：“为什么发生这种事呢？”
And the Lord said, "The sons in your womb shall be divided and become two nations."
而主对他说：“你腹中的儿子将成为两国。” Genesis
tells us that Esau came out first, red and covered in hair.
创世纪告诉我们，先出生的是以扫，全身红彤彤，都是毛发。
The Hebrew word for red is Edom, and the Hebrew word for hair is Seir.
而希伯来文 红色这个词是 Edom 以东，而毛发这个词叫 Seir， 就是今天的西尔。
Bible speaks of the land of Seir and the land of Edom.
圣经里面讲到西尔之地、以东地。
In other words, Jacob represents Israel and Esau represents Edom.
换句话说，雅各代表以色列，而以扫象征的是以东。
The Bible says that Israel will be surrounded by Edom when Jesus returns, and that he will judge and resolve this.
圣经讲到，耶稣再来的时候，以色列将被以东包围，而耶稣要审判解决这一切的事。
Messiah also speaks about it. When the Messiah returns, his garments will be splattered with the blood of Edom.
圣经也提到弥赛亚，弥赛亚返回时，他的衣服将被以东的血弄污。
Edom today presented by the Palestinians, what is now Hamas.
而今天以东的代表就是这些巴勒斯坦人，像今天加萨以及哈马斯。
When Jacob came out directly after his brother Esau being born, he took hold of Esau's heel, possibly not to allow kick and kill him.
那雅各出生的时候呢，他紧抓着以扫的脚跟，很可能呢是不被允许他，所以那个以东呢就以扫就不断的踢他，想杀了他。
The Hebrew name for Jacob is Yaakov, and Akov means heel.
希伯来文雅各这个字叫 Yaakov， 而 Akov 就是那个字根的意思呢，就是脚跟。
The first letter of Yaakov is a yud, which means hand. In other words, a hand grasping a heel.
而它的第一个字母，那个 Yaakov 的第一个字母是 yud， 那它的意思是手，代表有一只手抓着一个脚跟。
Interestingly, heel in Hebrew also means the target of the serpent.
很有意思哦，在希伯来文这个脚跟，它也同时代表蛇的目标。
The Bible tells us that both brothers were two extremes, completely opposite of each other.
圣经告诉我们，这两个兄弟呢，是非常极端，完全不一样的人。
Jacob was the son of promise, God's covenant, the fisherman.And Esau was a hunter.
雅各是上帝应许的儿子，是个渔夫，是上帝承诺他们的，而以扫却是个猎人。
So what is the definition of both a fisherman and a hunter?
那这样子，渔夫、猎人，他们的定义是什么呢？
A fisherman is someone who attracts his target with bait, and a hunter is one who pursues his target with force and with fear.
渔夫是使用饵来吸引他目标的人，可是猎人却是使用强力恐惧来追他的目标的人。
So who were God's original fishermen?
这样，上帝最起初的渔夫是谁？
God's covenant people, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and David, and Jesus will be the ultimate fisherman when he returns.
而上帝真正的渔夫就是他起初立约的百姓，像亚伯拉罕、以撒、雅各、大卫，而最终耶稣再来才是我们最终极的渔夫。
So who were God's original hunters?
这样，上帝起初的猎人是谁呢？
Nimrod was Satan's first original hunter. He fought against the Abrahamic covenant.
而宁禄是撒旦最首先的猎人，他跟亚伯拉罕的盟约来抵挡对抗。
Ishmael, Isaac's brother, is the second hunter.
以实玛利就是亚瑟以扫的哥哥，是第二位猎人。
Esau, the brother of Jacob, the third hunter.
以扫雅各的哥哥呢，就是第三位猎人。
So what about David? Did David's covenant include a hunter?
那大卫呢？在大卫的盟约当中有没有包含猎人？
Certainly. David's hunter was Goliath the Philistine, the giant who was felled by David's slingshot.
当然有，大卫的猎人就是那个非利士人哥利亚。你记得那个被他甩石击拳的石头击中的猎人，巨人吗？
And the new covenant was no different. There was also a hunter.
新约也没有差别，当中也有猎人在。
Herod, who pretended to be the king of the Jews, was of Esau's lineage.
而希律，他假装自己他是犹太人，实际上他就是以扫的后代。
When the Messiah was born, he was so jealous and he wanted to get rid of Jesus to avoid the fulfillment of the new covenant.
而弥赛亚诞生的时候，他非常非常嫉妒生气，就想杀掉耶稣，避免新约真正的成就。
Jesus will be the ultimate fisherman when he returns, and he will destroy the ultimate hunter, Satan.
耶稣再来，他就是我们最终极的渔夫，而他也要摧毁终极的猎人，就是撒旦。
Satan hates God's prophetic calendar. He hates God's master plan. And that's why Israel continues to be historically persecuted to this day.
撒旦最痛恨上帝整个全盘的计划，痛恨上帝救恩的计划。所以你看，整个历史当中，以色列一直是被人追赶的一个目标。
From the Egyptians to the Amalekites, the Midianites, the Moabites, the Ammonites, the Amorites, the Philistines, the Assyrians, the Babylonians, the Persians, the Romans, the Nazis, and today Iran, Hamas, and Hezbollah.
而不管从埃及到亚玛利人、米甸人、摩押人、亚门人、亚摩利人、非利士人、亚述人、巴比伦人、波斯人、罗马人、纳粹，一直到今天看到的伊朗、哈马斯和真主党。
But you shall utterly destroy them, the Hittite, the Amorite, the Canaanite, and the Perizzite, the Hivite, and the Jebusite, as the Lord your God has commanded you.
只要照耶和华你神所吩咐的，将这赫人、亚摩利人、迦南人、比利洗人、西北人、耶布斯人都灭绝净尽。
God has been clear throughout the Bible. He wants to wipe them out, those who mingle God's seed.
上帝在圣经讲的非常清楚，他要彻底消灭所有那些跟他后裔混杂的猎人。
It's not without a reason that God asked King Saul.To kill Agag, king of the Amalekites, but Saul did not destroy the king.
上帝要求扫罗杀了亚玛利人的王亚甲是有理由的，然而扫罗却没有遵从上帝的指示。
And because Saul did not kill this spirit of anti-Semitism, the demonic evil terror still lives today.
就因为扫罗并没有杀掉这个反犹太主义的灵，所以这样邪恶恐怖的到今天仍然存在。
The next moment in scripture we read about King Agag is in the story of Esther, where we meet an evil, demonic guy named Haman, who wanted to destroy the Jewish people.
而亚甲王他这样的灵，在以斯帖记里面又看到他出现了，一个很可怕的、充满邪恶的人叫哈曼，而他想要摧毁所有犹太人。
Haman was a descendant of Agag, an Amalekite.
哈曼是亚甲的后裔哦，他是亚玛利人。
I won't go into the story of Esther today, but since we are talking about fulfilled prophecies, I want to share a fascinating story.
那当然我今天不会进到以斯帖的故事里面来分享，可是既然我们要从圣经当中了解今天的整个的情况的话，我觉得在这个上头需要我们来探讨。
At the very end of Esther's story, they hanged this evil Haman, including his 10 sons, on the gallows.
在以斯帖记最后面，他们讲到这个恶人哈曼，甚至包含他十个儿子，全部都吊在那绞架上。
The Bible tells us that after this, the king promises Esther, "Whatever you want, I will give it to you."
圣经讲到，当时的王就跟以斯帖承诺说，无论你要什么，我必赐给你。
And here Esther has a very strange request.
以斯帖这儿有一个很奇怪的请求。
If it pleases the king, let it be granted to do tomorrow also as today, and let Haman 10 sons be hanged upon the gallows.
王若以为美，求你准书山的犹大人明日也照今日的旨意行，并将哈曼十个儿子的尸首 挂在木架上。
Esther asked the king to hang Haman's 10 son again, to repeat this the next day.
以斯帖竟然请求王第二天再一次把哈曼十个儿子再挂上去，重复今天。
And this is what happened, which is very, very strange. So why?
这个情况非常非常奇怪啊，那为什么呢？
On October 16, 1946, after World War II, 10 Nazi leaders were hanged in Nuremberg, Germany.
在1946年10月16日，二次大战结束之后，有十名纳粹的领袖在德国的纽伦堡判了绞刑处决。
This is exceptional because hanging was not common anymore.
这个是很奇怪的，因为当时已经很少再用绞刑了。
Interesting, but perhaps a coincidence.
很有意思，是巧合吗？
Not really, because the Torah lists the 10 names of the sons of Haman.
其实不然，因为在妥拉当中真的就清楚写下哈曼十个儿子的名字。
And interestingly, the names are written from top to bottom instead of right to left.
很有意思啊，这些名字是从上往下写，不是从右往左写。
And even more interesting, three letters are made small and one large. Tav, Shin, and Zayin are written small, and the Vav is written large.
还有很有意思的，有三个字母写的特别小，而其中一个字母写的特别大。Tav, Shin, Zayin 这三个写的比较小 ，a Vav 写的比较大。
So what is the meaning of these unusual large letters?
那这些特别放大的字母有什么特别的意思呢？
It represents the Hebrew year 5707, which is 1946.
这正代表的是希伯来年历的5707，正好是1946年。
God is amazing.
上帝很神奇的。
Behold, I am going to send for many fishermen, declares the Lord, and they will fish for them. And afterwards, I will send for many hunters, and they will hunt them from every mountain and every hill and from the clefts of the rocks.
耶和华说，我要招许多打鱼的，把以色列人打上来，然后我要招许多打猎的，从各山上、各网上、各石穴中猎取他们。
Jeremiah writes about the final end-time exodus where God brings his people Israel back to the promised land.
耶利米已经讲到在末世最大最后的一个回归，就上帝要将他的百姓以色列带回到应许之地。
Return of all Jewish people to Zion, the so-called lost sheep.
让所有犹太人回到锡安，就是那群迷失的羊。
So who are these lost sheep?
那这些迷失的羊是谁啊？
The lost sheep are the two houses of Israel.
迷失的羊就是以色列的二家。
The house of Israel, the 10 northern tribes, and the house of Judah, the 2 southern tribes, Judah and Benjamin.
以色列家就是北方的十个支派，而犹大家是南边的两个支派，就是犹大和便雅悯。
Both houses follow other gods and they rejected God's commandments.
这两家里头都充满各式各样的神，他们完全弃绝上帝的诫命了。
And God gets so angry and he mentions, "You are not my people and I am not your God."
上帝非常愤怒，他说，你们不做我的子民，我也不做你们的神。
I scattered them amongst the nations, but they will remember me and they will return.
我虽然播散他们在列国中，他们必在远方纪念我，他们与儿女都必存活且得归回。
God asked Ezekiel to take 2 sticks and write Ephraim and Judah, the 2 houses of Israel on them.
上帝要求以西结拿两根木杖，在上头写了以法莲和犹大来代表以色列二家。
And he asked Ezekiel to take the sticks in one hand and promise that he will reunite them again.
他叫以西结把这两根木杖用一只手拿起来，代表他们这两家要再一次团聚。
Jesus says, I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
耶稣说，我奉差遣不过是到以色列家迷失的羊那里去。
It's all about the parable of the prodigal son, the long-lost son Israel, who left the father to sin, but ultimately returns to the father.
而这就是那个浪子的比喻。你记得，就是这个浪子就是以色列了。他离开他的父亲，出去挥霍、放纵、犯罪，但最终要回到他的父面前。
For I will bring them back into their land, which I gave to their fathers.
圣经说，我要领他们再入我从前赐给他们列祖的地。
We need to understand that everything is only about Israel and Jerusalem.
我们要明白，这一切都是关乎以色列和耶路撒冷。
Ezekiel records, this is Jerusalem and I have set her at the center of the nations.
以西结这样记载说，这就是耶路撒冷，我曾将它安置在列邦之中，列国都在它的四围。
Israel is the center and we Gentiles are grafted in.
以色列是中心，而我们这些外邦人是嫁接插居在其中。
Jews and Gentiles will be saved, but first the lost sheep of Israel.
犹太人、外邦人都将得救，但首先是以色列家中迷失的羊。
John says the salvation is from the Jews, and Paul confirms Jews first.
约翰说，救恩从犹太人而来，保罗也印证说，犹太人首先是犹太人。
There's no replacement theology. The church has not replaced Israel.
所以根本没有所谓的替代神学，教会没有办法去取代以色列的。
In 1948, when Israel became a nation, the end-time fishermen were released.
1948年，以色列突然成国的时候，末世的渔夫就这样释放出来了。
The Hebrew word for the final return of the Jewish people is called Aliyah.
而希伯来文讲到最终回归到耶路撒冷这个词就叫 Aliyah.
Aliyah means ascending or going up, spiritually seen as the return to Jerusalem.
Aliyah 的意思是差派或是往上走，在灵里的意思就是要回归耶路撒冷。
So let's see where the original hunters are today.
让我们来看看起初那些猎人今天在哪里呢？
The area of Nimrod is modern-day Iran, Syria, or Iraq.
古代尼禄就是现今的伊朗、叙利亚和伊拉克。
Ishmael's territory, Saudi Arabia.
以实玛利的地界是在沙特阿拉伯。
Esau is Edom, Palestinians.
以扫就是以东，今天的巴勒斯坦人。
Goliath, Philistia, modern-day Gaza, controlled by Hamas.
而哥利亚，这非利士人，就是现今的加萨，就是现在这些哈马斯统治的地区。
And all these hunters have two things in common. They hate Israel, and their background is Islam.
所有这些猎人有两个共通点。首先，他们痛恨以色列，再来，他们的背景都是伊斯兰教。
In other words, the final conflict is between Israel and Islam.
换句话说，最终的冲突是在以色列和伊斯兰之间。
We see a seed war unfolding in Israel today, but eventually there will be a peace agreement.
今天在以色列那里看到，不过是一个种子战争开始慢慢展开，而最终将会达成和平协议的。
And this peace covenant will be the beginning of tribulation, the last 7 years before Jesus returns.
而这个和平条约就是最后灾难的起头，耶稣再来之前的最后七年。
But according to the Bible, it's better that we not get optimistically excited about this peace agreement because it will not end well.
那按圣经的记载，我们对于他们这个所谓的和平协议不要太兴奋，因为这和平最终没有很好的结局。
Gog and Magog is on the horizon, and scripture tells us that Israel will be attacked the moment they live in peace.
哥格马各已经要登场了。圣经告诉我们，最终在以色列人享受平安生活的时候，将受到攻击。
It is because Israel's leaders will put their trust in this covenant and in the Antichrist, who pretends to be their friend and not in the God of Israel.
因为以色列的领袖，他们信任这样的和平协议，信任这些敌基督，而不是信任以色列的神。
Scripture teaches us that the signing of this covenant will herald the tribulation, the grand final.
而圣经告诉我们，当他们签下这个和平的盟约的时候，就引进真正的大灾难，是最后的大结局。
And only halfway through the seven-year period when the covenant is broken, will Israel's leadership finally recognize the true nature of the one with whom they signed the covenant.
而到了这七年期限的中间，他们才突然发现，他们已经打破这个和平协议，开始来攻击、来残杀的时候，以色列的领袖才发现，到底他们是跟谁签了这样的合约。
Because what is the signing of this covenant, this agreement about?
因为到底签的这个协议，它的目的是什么呢？
To divide Israel in two, the main condition of the peace treaty is that there must be a homeland for the Palestinians.
就是把以色列的国土分裂为二，让其中一块变成巴勒斯坦的家乡。
And what does the Father say about this division of his land?
天父讲到要把他的土地分割，他怎么说的？
And for behold, in those days and at that time, when I restore the fortunes of Judah and Jerusalem, I will gather all the nations and bring them down to the valley of Jehoshaphat. Then I will enter into judgment with them. There, on behalf of my people and my inheritance Israel, whom they have scattered among the nations, and they have divided up my land.
到那日，我使犹大和耶路撒冷被掳之人归回的时候，我要聚集万民，带他们下到约沙法谷，在那里施行审判，因为他们将我的百姓，就是我的产业以色列，分散在列国中，又分取我的土地。
There is no valley of Jehoshaphat. It's translated as Jehovah's judgment.
其实在以色列没有什么山谷叫做约沙法谷的，它字面翻译的意思就是耶和华的审判。
Jesus will judge the nations when he returns, those who divided his father's land, because the father forbids dividing his land.
耶稣回来，他必要审判那些将主的土地分割为二的人，因为主耶和华若不将奥秘指他仆人，众先知就一无所行。
Surely God does nothing unless he reveals his secret counsel to his servants, the prophets.
所以主要行任何事之前，先将他的奥秘分享给他的先知，他的仆人。
What do the prophets say about this peace contract?
那先知们对于这个和平协议是怎么说的呢？
Therefore, hear the word of the Lord, O scoffers, who rule this people who are in Jerusalem, because you have said, we've made a covenant with death and with Sheol, we've made a pact.
所以你们这些亵慢的人，就是辖管住在耶路撒冷这百姓的，要听耶和华的话。你们曾说，我们与死亡立约，与阴间结盟。
Isaiah is clear.They made a covenant with death, with hell, a covenant with the Antichrist.
以赛亚讲得很清楚，他们是跟死亡、跟阴间结盟，就是跟敌基督达成协议。
Jeremiah is clear about it. They have healed the brokenness of my people superficially, saying, peace, peace, but there is no peace.
耶利米讲得很清楚啊，他们轻轻呼呼地医治我百姓的损伤，说平安了，平安了，其实没有平安。
Ezekiel is clear about it. It's definitely because they have misled my people by saying peace when there is no peace.
以西结讲得也很清楚，因为他们诱惑我的百姓说平安，其实没有真平安。
Micah is clear about it. Thus says the Lord concerning the prophets who lead my people astray. When they have something to bite with their teeth, they cry peace. But against him who puts nothing in their mouths, they declare holy war.
尼迦也讲得很清楚，论到使我民走岔路的先知，他们的牙齿有所嚼的，他们就呼喊说平安了，凡不供给他们吃的，他们就预备攻击他。
Paul is clear about it. While they are saying peace and safety, then destruction will come upon them suddenly, like labor pains upon a woman with child, and they will not escape.
保罗讲得也很清楚啊，人正说平安稳妥的时候，灾祸忽然临到他们，如同产难临到怀胎的妇人一样，他们绝不能逃脱。
The great and final war is on the horizon. It's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when.
所以那最大的、最后的征战已经是视线所及的了，已经不再是会不会发生的问题，而是何时发生了。
Jacob's trouble is the biblical term for the final conflict, the final war that ends all wars, called the Great Tribulation or the Great Distress.
而雅各的苦难，就是最终在世界末了所有结束所有战争的战争，被称为大灾难或是大压力的时候。
This final war is called the War of Gog and Magog and begins in the north.
而这最后的战役被称为哥格马各之战，它是从北方开始。
And all the nations mentioned in this last war are Middle East and North African countries.
而在所有提到最后战役当中的国家，都是在中东和北非的国家。
Magog, Meshech,Tubal, Gomer, and Tokarma are all located in ancient Asia Minor, modern-day Turkey.
圣经讲到马各、米舍、图巴、戈麦、托加马，这些都是在古代小亚细亚那边的地区，就是今天的土耳其。
Persia is modern Iran, Kush, Sudan, and Put, modern-day Libya.
波斯是现代的伊朗。古时就是苏丹，而福是今天的利比亚。
Sheba and Dedan is modern day Saudi Arabia.
示巴底旦是现代的沙特阿拉伯。
And the invasion Gog Magog takes place before Jesus returns.
而哥格马各的战役入侵是在耶稣再来之前发生的。
Sheba and Dedan and the merchants of Tarshish with all its villages will say to you, Have you come to capture spoil? Have you assembled your company to seize plunder, to carry away the silver and gold, to take away cattle and goods, to capture great spoil?
示巴人、底但人、他使的客商和其间的少壮狮子都必问你说，你来要抢财为掳物吗？你聚集军队要夺货为掠物吗？要夺取金银，掳去牲畜财货吗？要抢夺许多财宝为掳物吗？
This is an important verse here about what is going to happen during the Great Tribulation.
这个很重要哦，讲到在大灾难当中发生什么事情。
Sheba and Dedan is modern day Saudi Arabia and Tarshish is seen as Spain,Britain or Italy, probably today seen as Europe.
示巴跟底但就是今天的沙特阿拉伯，而他施，他可能指的是西班牙、英国、意大利，就是今天我们所谓的欧洲。
We read here that during the Great Tribulation, both Saudi Arabia and let's call it Europe seem to be aligned with Israel, asking the Antichrist what his intentions are regarding Israel.
而在圣经里面讲得很清楚，到时候沙特阿拉伯就是还有包含在欧洲这些国家，他们会来询问敌基督，到底你对以色列的意图为何？
Mecca, the capital of Saudi Arabia, will be destroyed according to scripture.
按照圣经，麦加就是沙特阿拉伯的首都将会全然被摧毁。
And then the ten horns which you saw and the beast,These will behate the harlot, and will make her desolate and naked, and will eat her flesh, and will burn her up with fire.
你所看见的那十角与兽，并恨这淫妇，使他冷落赤身，又要吃他的肉，用火将他烧尽。
So why would Iran, a Muslim country, destroy Mecca, the Islamic center of worship in the world?
像伊朗，一个穆斯林的国家，为什么会去摧毁麦加？因为麦加是全世界伊斯兰朝拜的中心啊。
Because Saudi Arabia owns one-fifth of the world's proven oil fields, and it sells its oil around the world, mainly to the West.
因为沙特阿拉伯，它拥有全球五分之一已经探明的这些石油的储量，它把石油销售到世界各地，主要销售给西方国家。
With whom the kings of the earth committed acts of immorality, and those who dwell on the earth were made drunk with the wine of her immorality.
地上的君王与他行淫，住在地上的人喝醉了他淫乱的酒。
So what is the wine of the desert that has made the earth drunk today? Oil.
在沙漠当中，是什么能够让今天的世界全部喝醉？这酒就是石油。
The oracle of Duma, Arabia, and all the glory of Kedar will come to an end.
论杜马的末世，或向有人声向希尔呼问我说：“守望的夜里如何？守望的夜里如何？”
Where are Duma, Arabia, and Kedar?
虽有杜马。阿拉伯和基达
all located in Arabian Peninsula, present-day Saudi Arabia.
他们全部都在阿拉伯半岛上面，就是今天的沙特阿拉伯。
Isaiah says, "Fallen, fallen is Babylon."
以赛亚就说，巴比伦倾覆了，倾覆了。
And how will the enemy attack Saudi Arabia and set the oil fields on fire?
那仇敌怎么样来攻击沙特阿拉伯，让整个油田全部燃烧起来呢？
And I lifted my eyes, and I saw, and behold, a flying scroll. And he said to me, What do you see? And I answered, I see a flying scroll, and its length is 20 cubits, and its width 10 cubits.
我又举目观看，竟有一飞行的书卷。他问我说，你看见什么？我回答说，我看见一飞行的书卷，长20肘，宽10肘。
Interestingly enough, Zechariah saw something flying at a time when nothing was flying, except birds, of course.
那很有意思啊，撒加利亚在那边看到的东西是飞在空中的，当时候除了鸟，没有东西在天上飞嘛。
He saw a scroll, a cylinder shape object. So could it be that Zechariah saw a nuclear missile setting fire to the Saudi oil fields? I think it's possible.
他看到那个飞行的东西长相是那种长长像书卷一样的，所以有没有可能撒加利亚看见的就是一个核导弹，它能够让沙地的油田全部引火呢？
For in 1 hour such great wealth has been laid waste.And every shipmaster, every passenger and sailor, and as many as make their living by sea, stood at a distance, and they were crying out. And they saw the smoke of their burning, saying, What city is like the great city? And they threw dust on their heads, and they were crying out, weeping and mourning, saying, Woe, woe, the great city, in which all who had ships at sea became rich by her wealth.For in 1 hour, she has been laid waste.
一时之间，这么大的负荷就归于无有了。凡船主和坐船往各处去的，并众水手，连所有靠海为业的，都远远的站着，看见烧他的鹰，烟就喊着说：“有何城能比这大城呢？”他们又把尘土撒在头上，哭泣悲哀，喊着说：“哀哉，哀哉，这大城啊！”翻译。有船在海中的都因他的珍宝成了富足，他竟在一时之间就成了荒场。
Here we read that people are watching the burning oil fields from a distance from the Red Sea, an important shipping route.
而很有可能他在描述，就是人们看见到时候远远看到远处的油田燃烧成一片，而他们从红海，是一个很重要船运的海道，看见的。
And they throw dust on their heads, a typical Middle Eastern custom during mourning.
他们把灰撒在头上，这对中东地区，当他们在哀痛悲痛的时候，一个典型的习俗。
Interestingly, on the first day of Sukkot, the Feast of Tabernacles, the Jewish people read the end-time war of Gog and Magog.
很有意思哦，在祝棚节，在犹太人庆祝这个节期的时候，他们会去诵读在末世哥格马各的战争。
It's fascinating to see the connection between the last war and Sukkot, the time of Jesus' second coming.
很有意思看见这末世的战争和祝棚节彼此的关联，这正是耶稣要再来之前的象征。
Anyway, it's all about the seed war between Ishmael and Isaac, Esau and Jacob, a jihad holy war.
所以这一切都是以扫跟以实玛利、雅各跟以扫之间这个种子的战争，他们今天所谓的 jihad 这个圣战就是这样。
It's all about fighting and replacing Israel with an Islamic Palestinian state, which is not a Middle East issue, but a global issue of all nations, fully supported and led by the United Nations.
而在这里都是要跟以色列人征战，要让巴勒斯坦国来取代以色列国。这不只是中东的事情，这是全世界都需要关注的事情。而你看到这些战争，全然是由联合国来支持的。
What we see happening today is a reflection of what is happening in heaven.
我们今天在地上看到的，正是反映出在天上发生的事。
The end-time battle begins in heaven, and then the final battle will be concluded on earth.
末日的战争是从天上开始，而最终的结局是在地上发生。
And there was war in heaven, Michael and his angels waging war with the dragon.
在天上就有了征战，米迦勒同他的使者与龙征战，龙也同他的使者去征战。
And what will be the last kingdom on earth be?
那地上最后的一个国是什么？
In my opinion, Turkey, the Ottoman Empire.
我个人的想法会是土耳其，就是奥斯曼帝国。
My advice is to watch the Middle East carefully, especially Iran and Turkey. But remember, Israel is the foundation of God's master plan from beginning to end.
那我非常建议大家一定要留意观察中东，特别是伊朗和土耳其。可是千万不要忘了，以色列才是上帝整体计划当中的根基。
What a time to be alive! What a time to be alive! Because there are so many prophecies being fulfilled before our eyes.
哇，我们活在何等了不起的时代，因为有太多圣经的预言就在我们眼前实现了。
When the Romans destroyed the ancient nation of Israel, Judea, they slaughtered the Jewish people, and they renamed God's land after the Philistines, the people of ancient Goliath.
当罗马人他们摧毁当时以色列的国家，就是犹大以色列的时候，他们残杀那边的百姓，同时把上帝在那儿土地按他们的敌人非利士人，就是哥利亚，他们为了要羞辱以色列人，就取他们的名字来成为这个土地的名字，变成巴勒斯坦。
Palestine means the land of the Philistines.
巴勒斯坦本身的意义就是非利士人之地。
God loves all people, but he gave the land to Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and their children.
上帝爱所有的人。但这块地是上帝赐给亚伯拉罕、以撒、雅各和他们子孙的土地。
The Gaza Strip was the headquarters of Israel's enemies in ancient times.
在古代，加萨走廊这一块正是以色列仇敌他们的总部。
And what we see happening today is all part of an ancient war, a replay of an ancient war, a seed war.
实际上，我们今天看到的这一切。都不过是古代战役的重演，就是古代呢，你的后裔、你的子嗣要征战的战役。
An enmity between the seed of the woman, Israel, and the seed of Satan.
就是那女子的后裔，就是以色列，还有撒旦的后裔，他们彼此之间为仇的事。
It's all a replay. There's nothing new under the sun.
这都是重播了，太阳底下没有新鲜事啊。
Samson was also wounded, humiliated, and abused in Gaza. They captured him, and the end result was that Gaza was left in the ruins of his temple.
当时三孙他受伤、被羞辱、被虐待，也是在加萨发生的，而最后的结果是整个加萨全部被摧毁。
It has been the agenda from the very first days.And it's the agenda for the last days that we are in.
这从一起初他们就已经有这样的图谋，而在最后的日子，就是我们所在的日子，还是一样的企图。
We see anti-Semitism rising around the world. Babylon rises, but will fall.
我们在世界各地都看到这个反犹太主义的兴起。巴比伦虽然崛起，但将崩溃。
Woe to those who call evil good and good evil.
称善为恶，恶为善的人有祸了。
We must resist and fight any demonic influence directed against Israel.
所以我们一定要坚持，要征战那些直接来攻击以色列的邪恶。
Israel still lives because the God of Israel lives.The Messiah of Israel lives, and the Word of Israel lives, the Hope of Israel lives, and those who believe and are grafted into Israel will live because of Israel.
以色列仍然存活，因为以色列的神活着，所以以色列的盼望是活着，以色列话语是活着，以色列的国家是活着，而所有相信我们是插枝进入以色列的，也要活着。因为有以色列。
God uses evil men to bring his people to their knees and repent.
上帝使用这些恶人，叫他的子民再次回到屈膝在主的面前来悔改。
God will use tribulation, men's war to bring his people to their knees.
上帝可以使用灾难，人类的战争，叫他的百姓都能在他面前屈膝。
But my God is grace.My God will never do this to me.
但我的上帝是恩典啊，我的上帝不会这样对我的。
And my question would be, who told you this? Because it's not in the Bible.
我就要请教你了，谁跟你说的？圣经从没这样说过。
It all started in the beginning when Satan asked Eve in the Garden of Eden.
全部都是才最起初开始的。你记得撒旦在伊甸园怎么样问夏娃的吗？
Did God really say you can't eat from that tree?
神真的说过你不能吃那棵树上的果子吗？
Did God really say he came to abolish the law?
神岂是真说他来要废掉律法吗？
Did he really say the day of the Lord is on Sunday?
他其实真说主的日子是星期天吗？
Did God really say my feasts are Jewish feasts?
上帝其实真说我的节期就是犹太人的节期吗？
Did God really say we can forget Shabbat?
神其实真说我们可以忘记安息日吗？
No, he didn't. God doesn't lie, the enemy does, and it's about time that we break church errors.
没有，他从来没有。上帝从不说谎，这是该让所有教会被唤醒的时候了。
The war in the north, that we see unfolding right now is not the final war. It's not Jacob's trouble. It is the war that sets the stage for this coming deceptive peace.
那我们目前看到的战争，并不是真正最后的战役，不是那个雅各之灾。而现在这个战争不过是要来欺哄世界，因为他们要达成协议，看见中东能够有和平。
The Antichrist is going to deceive Israel, the nations, the world into believing that after this war we will enter a new era of peace, safety and stability in the Middle East.
敌基督要经由这场战役来欺骗全世界各个国家，包含以色列在内，让他相信终于在中东地区能够平安稳妥了。
What is happening today has been prepared for a number of years.
其实今天发生的事情，他们已经花了好些年在准备了。
Iran through Hezbollah, or at the northern border of Israel with Lebanon, has been stockpiling tens of thousands short and long-range missiles, all focused on one to destroy Israel.
伊朗从他北部的边界那里，还有黎巴嫩那儿，他们在以色列北部那边的边界，他们已经准备了成百上千的这些导弹、飞弹、这些炸弹，要来对着以色列攻击他了。
This evil spirit did not leave the world. It's still in the earth today. Modern day Persia, Iran.
这样邪恶的灵没有离开世界哦，它今天仍然存在在世上，就是所谓的波斯现代的伊朗。
But it seems that people today don't understand evil.
好像今天世界人不了解什么叫邪恶哎。
Because we see all over the world that people are demonstrating for Palestine.
因为世界各地很多人在那示威游行，要支持巴勒斯坦。
I ask why? Because we didn't hate the Germans in World War II, we hated the Nazis.
就问为什么？因为二次大战的时候，我们恨的不是德国人哦，我们恨的是纳粹呀。
We don't hate the Palestinians today, we hate Hamas, Hezbollah, and those who do evil.
我们今天恨的不是巴勒斯坦人，我们恨恶的是哈马斯、真主党那些行恶的人。
Decent people, and the majority are decent people, will respond, let's be decent and call for a ceasefire and let's negotiate.
而那些所谓端庄的人、大度的人，因为就是正常人应该都是这样端庄大度，对不对？他们就呼喊说应该要停火，让我们开始谈判。
This is how most people today condemn Israel.
这是为什么今天这么多人在定以色列人的罪。
But evil, barbaric people with evil agendas who kills babies and then cut off their heads are not interested in negotiating. They are interested in doing evil.
而但是那些真正行恶的人，那些入侵、残杀妇女、孩童、把孩子头砍下来的人，他们要的根本不是跟你谈判，他们要的就是继续的行恶，继续的摧毁你们。
The whole world is now against Israel, but God in Scripture is clear: wipe them out.
今天全世界在谴责以色列的时候，但上帝在圣经当中讲的非常明确，要将他们从地上灭绝。
Today it seems really happening because according to prophecy, all the players are in place.
今天感觉真的要发生了。因为按照所有的预言所说，所有那些要参与的人都已经就位了。
Things are happening right now that have never happened in any generation.
今天在发生的一些事情，在过去所有时代从来没有发生过。
Jesus gave us the book of Revelation not to panic, but to prepare us.
耶稣赐下启示录给我们，不是让我们惊慌，而是预备我们。
And what do we do?We deny revelation, we skip it, we don't prepare our people, which is a shame.
但我们做什么？我们根本否决启示录，也不预备我们的百姓，完全不明白发生什么状况，真是太丢人了。
Jesus said, don't be troubled when you see these things happening. Lift up your eyes, your redemption draws near.
耶稣讲的，当你看见这些事的时候，不要惊慌，一有这些事，你们就当挺身昂首，因为你们得赎的日子近了。
He taught us to prepare for times like these. Don't be a foolish as the five foolish virgins.
他告诉我们要为这样的日子预备好，不要像那愚昧的童女，那五个童女没有预备油一样，这样子惊慌失措。
Don't think, I will fall under grace. Nothing will happen to me and my family. It will be naive.Look what happened in Israel, God's people living in the kibbutz.
你不要觉得说，哎呀，我在上帝恩典里面，我不会经历任何东西。你这样的想法就太天真了。你看看原来在以色列南方所安居定稳妥的那些以色列人，他们发生什么？
Satan is real.
撒旦是真实的。
The moment that we feel like we need to open our Bible to study, Satan will open his box of tricks and attack us. trying to separate us from God.
一旦我们翻开圣经，想要阅读上帝话语的时候，撒旦就打开他的书卷，不断吸引我们分心，去离开上帝，离间我们跟上帝的关系。
Suddenly we have no inspiration. Suddenly we find boring. Suddenly we are not interested in watching a movie on Netflix or playing our social media.
突然之间，哎呀，就没有动力了，突然就失去了兴趣，不想读神的话语了，就开始去看 Netflix 上面的电影啦，看我们手机上面的社群媒体。
It's arranged to keep us from truth.
很重要。是要保持自己在真理上的刚强。
Because when we have peace with God, we can have peace with others, and this is not His agenda.
我们要先跟上帝和好了，才能跟其他人和好，没有其他的方法了。
He prefers confusion and chaos, and to be honest, look at the world, He is doing a great job.
仇敌想做的就是让我们困惑不知所措。你看看今天的世界，他做的非常好的工作。
We need a collective desire to get down on our knees and say, Lord, we cry out in despair. We have no solution left.
而我们真的需要一起回转屈膝在主的面前，说主啊，我们绝望呼求，已经没有其他的解决方法了。
We need the shufa through tribulation.
经历这样的灾难。我们需要的是 teshuva 悔改。
Without tribulation, nothing will change because we don't want to change. We don't want to leave our earthly life. We just don't want to. So God will judge and give us a reason to get down on our knees and take us out of her Babylon.
而没有灾难，我们不会悔改，我们也不想悔改，我们太习惯、太安逸在今天世界的生活当中了。而上帝需要经由灾难，带着我们一起在绝望当中屈膝到他的面前，他才能将我们从巴比伦手中拯救出来。
You think there will be no judgment because we have the cross that we are already forgiven, but this is not what the Bible teaches, the church does.
我们觉得，哎呀，因为带了十字架，我们已经得赦免了，不用经历任何审判了。圣经从来不是这样教我们的，可能是某些教会宗派教导的。
It all started with Abraham's son, and it started with Rebecca and her two sons fighting in her womb.
都是从亚伯拉罕的后裔，从利百加的后裔，他两个儿子在母腹中间就开始争。
It started with Esau, the Amalekites, those who did not fight men, but killed the woman and the children to get rid of the seed, the bloodline.
而这一切是从以扫开始哦，这些亚玛利人，他们不是跟男人征战呢，反而专门杀害妇女，要亲自消灭他们所有的后裔，他们的血脉。
This battle already plays in the time of Moses, and what did Moses do?
这个战争早在摩西的时候就已经开始了。你记得摩西怎么做的吗
？He knew he couldn't win this demonic spiritual battle, so he did what God expected of him.
他知道这样邪恶的征战是他自己没办法打赢的，所以他照着上帝吩咐的方式来做。
He went up into the mountain and he prayed, and Aaron and others were to hold up his hand.
他上到山上去祷告，举起祷告，让亚伦跟户珥帮他举起他的手。
When his hand went down and stopped praying, they were losing the war. When they continued praying, they were winning.
当他手疲倦放下不祷告的时候，下面征战就开始输了。可当他高举双手再次祷告的时候，下面以色列人征战就得胜了。
And this is the message for us today.Pray. If we don't pray, we will lose our battle. If we pray, we will win.
这就是今天我们得到的信息，祷告。不祷告，你征战一定失败。当你祷告，就能征战得胜。
And that's why it was so wrong, evil in a sense, when John Nelson Darby came on stage and started teaching the church that the church has replaced Israel.
这就是为什么，当约翰纳尔逊达比他开始站上讲台来教导 教会已经取代以色列的时候，这是非常非常错误、非常邪恶的。
It is the same deceptive spirit that tells us that Israel will be punished and not the church.
同样欺哄的灵在告诉我们说，有一天受审的是以色列，教会不会被惩罚的。
It is the spirit of anti-Semitism, an evil, horrific spirit roaring around us, deceiving us.
这就是反犹太主义的灵，这是非常邪恶的灵，在我们身旁这样子怒吼，不断要欺哄蒙蔽我们。
Because how is it possible to see academic people, university people who teach at universities behave with such a hatred towards the Jewish people?
不然，你怎么样看到那些学业的在学界、学术界这些精英分子，他们的行为对犹太人的百姓竟然充满如此的仇恨呢？
Because it's supernatural.
因为这超自然的。
For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, powers, against the world forces of this darkness, the spiritual forces of wickedness in the heavenly places.
因我们并不是一书血气的征战，那是与那些执政的、掌权的、管辖着幽暗世界的，以及天空属灵界的恶魔征战。
There have been recent reports of millions of Iranians accepting Christ.Being visited in dreams by a man in white with scars. This is the other side of the story.
可是也有新闻告诉我们呢，有上百万的伊朗人，他们接受基督，哎，因为在梦中有一个穿着白色衣服，身上全身是疤痕的人，就是耶稣亲自造访他们。这是故事的另外一面了。
God is on both sides of the road. There will be tribulation for those who need tribulation, and he will save those who are already in tribulation and crying out.
那你看见上帝在这两方面都在工作，有一些需要苦难、灾难才会懂得自己要悔改的人，上帝就让他们经历灾难，而那些已经在灾难当中呼求的人，他就去拯救他们。
Our mission today is to set the alarm. It's happening. We must prepare for the return of Jesus. We must do teshuva and disconnect from the world.
而我们今天的使命就是要响起警钟，让他们知道预备好，耶稣快要再来了，要帮助这些人明白 teshuva, 要悔改，跟这个世界彻底断绝关系。
We must do three things. First, the Father,And end our sin.
我们需要做三件事。首先，来到父的面前，承认自己的罪。
Second, willing to repent for this sin to teshuva.
第二，我们愿意为自己的罪而悔改，叫 teshuva.
Third, give our hearts completely to Jesus and let the Holy Spirit guide our lives instead of leading it ourselves.
第三，将我们的心全然献给主耶稣，让圣灵指引我们的生命，而不是在自己主导生活了。
People who say that the end time prophecies are not being fulfilled today, that it's not happening, or that these signs have already been there,are ironically fulfilling Bible prophecy themselves.
那有些人他们说，哎呀，末世的预言根本今天还没有实现啦，那些征兆还没有存在在世界上面，很讽刺的。这些人说这些话，正是应验了圣经当中的预言。
So know this first of all, that in the last days, mockers will come with their mocking.Following after their own lust, saying, Where is the promise of his coming? For ever since the fathers fell asleep, all continues just as it was from the beginning of creation.
第一要紧的，该知道在末世必有好讥诮的人，随从自己的私欲出来讥诮说，主要降临的应许在哪里呢？因为从列祖睡了以来，万物与起初创造的时候仍是一样啊。
So Father, hear our voices.
天父，听我们的声音。
As we pray for our brothers and sisters in Eretz Yisrael,
因我们在为我们以色列的弟兄姐妹祷告祈求。
that they remain safe and protected.
让他们继续安全受到保护。
That they will soon triumph over these terrorists.
很快能战胜这些恐怖分子。
Who worship death and destruction and hatred.
而不再受到这样的仇恨摧毁的攻击。
Bring healing to the hearts of these evil terrorists.
也求你将心灵的医治带给这些邪恶的恐怖分子。
And let them lay down.
让他们能屈膝在你面前。
And completely cease their hate for your people.
完全结束他们对你百姓的仇恨。
That no weapon that is formed against Israel will prosper.
所有为攻击以色列打造的器械都不能利用。
Keep the men and the women safe.
保守那里男男女女平安。
As they defend your people and your nation Israel.
因为他们在护卫是你的百姓，你的国家以色列。
Father, we humbly ask you for your help.
天父，我们谦卑地求你帮助。
Your protection.
你的保守。
In these challenging times.
在这艰困的时刻。
May your peace reign.
愿你平安掌权。
And your will be done.
你旨意成就。
In Jesus' name, Amen.
奉耶稣的名, Amen.